I am totally the friend who sees something on social media and for sure direct messages it to everybody that I think would appreciate it. Like, I'm the annoying friend where every day, if you look in your inbox, you're gonna see like a link to an article, a link to a funny TikTok, an Instagram post. I do this every day. And my friends give me a hard time about it because when something's an everyday thing in our lives, we often call that a habit. Another way to say it is that habits are routine behaviors that we tend to do a lot. Things that are everyday kind of things. Our habits might be things like waking up at a certain time each day, or brushing our teeth, playing Xbox every day after school, chewing gum all the time, or scrolling through Instagram before we go to sleep. Some of us may do these things every once in a while, but others of us, well, we do them every day. They happen on a regular basis in our lives, and the more we do them, the more they become habit. You might be wondering, why are we talking about this? Well, because we want to help you develop some new daily habits. Things that you can do every day to help you get to know God better. Things that will make your relationship with God the center of an everyday kind of faith. What does it look like to connect with God? Well, let's start by thinking about the way you connect with your best friend. You care about your best friend and you want your relationship to grow, right? You want to know a lot about them and you want to be known. So you make an effort to do things that will help you stay close and connected. You talk or you text a lot. You hang out together. You do things that you both like to do. You make a habit of staying close and connected to them. And the more you do it, the better your relationship is. The same can be true with God. If we want to know Him better and keep growing in our faith, we have to make a habit of doing things every day that help us stay connected to Him. But for a lot of us, the idea of connecting with God is, well, a little confusing. Maybe you've been coming to church your whole life. Maybe you've been singing the songs, reading the Bible, and praying all the prayers, and you feel like you're doing all the right things. You're following all the rules and doing what you think God says you're supposed to do, but somehow you feel like it just isn't working. Ultimately, you don't feel closer to God no matter what you do. Or maybe you're new to all this faith stuff, and even though you believe in God, you don't feel like much has changed in your heart or life. You thought things were supposed to be different once you decided to believe in God, but you sort of just feel the same. Have you ever wondered, like, am I doing this wrong? Because I don't really feel connected to God at all. Or maybe you have no idea what to think about God. You're not even sure you want to connect with Him because you aren't sure He's even out there. I mean, how do you connect with a God who's invisible? And why would you want to try if you're not even sure you believe in Him in the first place? I think that no matter where you are on your faith journey, one thing is true for all of us. At the end of the day, we're all sort of asking the same questions. What does it really mean to connect with God? Why should I even want to connect with God? And what will connecting with God do for me right now? If you're asking any of those questions, I'm glad we're hanging out. Jesus actually explains what this looks like in a conversation he had with his disciples. The disciples were Jesus's closest followers while he was on earth. They were all eating together in what ended up being the last meal before Jesus was killed. The disciples were anxious because Jesus kept saying he was going to go away and they couldn't go with him. This was stressing the disciples out because they had no idea what Jesus leaving would mean for them. So, Jesus told the disciples something that would help them in the days ahead. Let's take a look. Yes, I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who remain in me and I in them will produce much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing. Now, I imagine the disciples may have been like vines and branches, like in a garden. What does gardening have to do with us? You might be thinking the same thing right now. Well, it's important to know that things like vines and branches were a part of their everyday world back then. Jesus picked these examples because he knew the disciples would understand them as he explained. So, what did Jesus mean when he called himself the vine? Well, you see, the branches depend on the vine completely. The vine is the foundation, it's the source of life. So in order to survive and thrive, the branches have to stay connected to the vine. So what Jesus was saying in this passage was that if the disciples wanted to keep going and growing in their faith, they had to find a way to stay connected to Jesus every day. Think about it like this. If you want your phone to keep working after the battery dies, what do you have to do? You plug it in. Your phone needs to be connected to the charger in order to keep working. Just like a branch needs to be connected to the vine to survive, a phone needs to be plugged into the charger in order to keep working. So basically, If Jesus were telling this to us today, he might say, I am the charger and you are the phone. In order to keep working, you need to be plugged into me. Or, as Jesus said, you need to remain in me. That's simply another way of saying that we need to stay connected with Jesus. Why? Because when we do, we'll produce much fruit. See, in order for branches to grow and flourish, they have to stay connected to the vine. As soon as they're removed or taken apart from the vine, they stop producing fruit the way they were meant to. They stop being able to grow. The same is true for us when it comes to our connection with God. And Jesus makes that connection possible for us. When Jesus died on the cross and rose from the dead, he took away the barrier that was between us and God. He created a way for us to directly connect to God himself. And if we stay connected with him, our lives will show it. Our relationships, our attitude, our choices, our words, all of that will be better because we're connected to God. If we stay close to him, we'll see the results of that in our lives, and we'll learn more about God in the process. Because connecting with God helps us know him better. And just like our phones need to connect to the source of power to keep working, we need to connect with God to keep going and growing in our faith. If we want to know more about God, and if we want our lives to show it, we have to stay connected to him. Because connecting with God helps us know him better. And when we connect with him, we better understand his goodness, his love, his compassion for us, and his perfect plan for our life. So, how can we do this? I think there really are two key pieces. First, spend time with God. Maybe for you that means making time to read your Bible or pray or sing worship songs or write some thoughts in your journal. Or maybe it's listening to music or going on a walk outdoors. Maybe it's just a commitment to show up here again next week. Whatever it is, I want you to make spending time with God a priority this week. No matter what you feel or don't feel, just commit to giving it a shot. Commit to showing up, to spending time with him, to connecting with him, because connecting with God helps us know him better. Second, do it every day. On the days when you feel disconnected from God, don't stop spending time with him, because the best way to reconnect is to keep spending time together. And the more time you spend together, the more connected you become. The best relationships in your life didn't become great after one conversation or hangout or experience. No, they grew over time. You had to keep showing up, keep talking, keep spending time together. The same is true with God. So make your faith a priority every day. Even when you feel disconnected from God, try to make it a habit and watch how your life changes because of it. Remember, connecting with God helps us know him better. The more you make connecting with God a habit in your life, the more you'll get to know him. If you're not sure where to start, I want you to consider starting today in your group. We have groups so that you can talk about things like this together. So open up to your group today about what connecting with God means to you.